Korea is trying to play its role in the world space exploration race, as they are now carrying out one of the greatest space missions of 2022. Korea Pathfinder Lunar Orbiter, or KPLO, South Korea's first lunar mission, was initially planned for December of 2018, but was postponed due to some technical difficulties. It is developed and managed by the Korea Aerospace Research Institute, or KARI. KPLO, or otherwise known as DANURI, was scheduled to launch in August 2022 to orbit the moon for 1 year, carrying an array of South Korean experiments and one US-built instrument. Welcome back to Liftoff, where we provide you the recent news about rocket launches, space news, and anything mysterious in space. Today we're going to find out how SpaceX launched a Korean Pathfinder lunar orbiter in space. Stay till the end to know about the successive missions of this project after landing on the moon. Before heading on to the video, make sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon so you never miss any of our updates. The objectives of KPLO are to develop indigenous lunar exploration technologies, demonstrate a space internet, and conduct scientific investigations of the lunar environment, topography, and resources. Moreover, this mission will discover potential landing sites which will assist in future human activities on the moon and beyond. KPLO officially launched in August 2022 aboard SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. The test lunar orbiter was bound to shoot toward the moon after its launch, using the ballistic lunar transfer method. This mission is very important for South Korea, as it is the first phase of their larger Korean Lunar Exploration Program, or KLEP, plans. In case KPLO succeeds, which we all hope it will, the second phase of the Korean exploration program will begin, which consists of a lunar day from Florida's Space Coast, marking the shortest turnaround time between launches at Cape Canaveral since 1967. SpaceX's Falcon 9 lifted off from the Space Launch Complex 41 at Cape Canaveral with the Korea Pathfinder Lunar Orbiter, which is a 1400 an Atlas V rocket launched with a U.S. military missile warning satellite at 6:29 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time from Pad 41, located about 2.5 kilometers north of SpaceX's launch complex. The time between last time it happened was when two rockets took off from Cape Canaveral on September 7th and 8th in 1967, when a Thor Delta G rocket and an Atlas Centaur rocket launched less than 10 hours apart. The Atlas Centaur sent NASA's Surveyor 5 lander to the moon, whereas the Thor Delta G rocket launched a recoverable spacecraft called Biosatellite 2 with a host of biological research experiments. South Korea has exceptional future ambitions in space exploration, including a robotic landing on the moon in the early 2030s, and the KPLO mission is a pathfinder for it. The probability of success for Korea's future ambitions is high, as they also signed up to join the NASA-led Artemis Accords, and could contribute to the U.S. Space Agency's Human Lunar Exploration Program. DANURI. The KPLO mission is also named DANURI, which is a combination of the words Dal and Nurida in Korean, and it means enjoying the moon. The mission's project scientist from the Korean Aerospace Research Institute, Enyuk Kim, said the basic idea of this mission is technological development and demonstration. He mentioned, "Also, using the science instruments, we are hoping to get some useful data on the lunar surface." The DANURI mission carries 6 different science instruments and technology demonstration payloads. They have several planes to test a new South Korean spacecraft platform that was designed for deep space operations, along with the latest communication, control, and navigation capabilities, including the validation of an interplanetary internet connection using a disruption-tolerant network. This mission has very specific objectives that include mapping the lunar surface to help select future landing sites, surveying resources like water ice on the moon, and probing the radiation environment near the moon. DANURI cost around $180 million to develop. SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket launched the KPLO spacecraft toward the moon on a fuel-efficient ballistic lunar transfer trajectory. This path is being pioneered by NASA's small Capstone spacecraft, a tech demo mission that took off in June on a rocket lab mission and is expected to slip into orbit around the moon in November. KPLO will take almost 4 months to complete the journey, unlike NASA's Apollo missions, which reached the moon in a few days after launching. The arrival date of KPLO at the moon is fixed for December 16th. The Falcon 9 propelled the spacecraft on a path that will take it near to the L1 Lagrange point, which is a gravitationally stable location nearly a million miles from the daytime side of the Earth that accumulates to almost four times farther than the Moon. The gravitational forces will pull the spacecraft back toward Earth and the Moon naturally, and the Korean probe will be captured in orbit by December 16th. Several propulsive maneuvers with the spacecraft's thrusters will steer Kplo into a circular low-altitude orbit about 60 miles from the lunar surface by New Year's Eve. So after a whole month of commissioning and tests, the spacecraft's year-long primary science mission should initiate by February 1st, and if the orbiter has enough fuel, the managers of this mission may consider an extended mission beginning in 2024. The launch on Thursday was the 34th flight of a Falcon 9 rocket this year, and a Kplo launch was also the 32nd space mission of the year from Cape Canaveral to fly into orbit or toward more distant destinations. At T-minus 35 minutes, SpaceX's launch team started loading super-chilled and densified kerosene and liquid oxygen propellants into the 229-foot-tall Falcon 9 vehicle that was stationed inside a firing room at a launch control center at Cape Canaveral. Helium pressurant was also released into the rocket in the last half hour of the countdown. The Falcon 9's Merlin main engines were thermally conditioned in the final 7 minutes before liftoff through a procedure known as a chill down. The Falcon 9's guidance and range safety systems were also configured for launch. Soon after the launch, Falcon 9 rocket vectored its 1.7 million pounds of thrust that was produced by 9 Merlin engines to steer east over the Atlantic Ocean. The rocket surpassed the speed of sound in almost 1 minute and then shut down its 9 main engines 2.5 minutes after liftoff. The booster stage was released from Falcon 9's upper stage and then fired from cold gas control thrusters and extended titanium grid fins to assist in the steering of the vehicle back into the atmosphere. Two incorporated braking pumps slowed down the rocket for landing on the drone ship, named Just Read the Instructions, or JTRI, around 400 miles downrange and approximately 9 minutes after liftoff. The booster flying on the Kplo mission is known as B1052. It was launched on its sixth trip to space and debuted as a side booster on two SpaceX Falcon Heavy missions in 2019. Later, SpaceX converted it to fly as a Falcon 9 rocket. As the first stage came back to Earth for landing, the Falcon 9's upper stage fired its single Merlin engine 2 times, first for 6 minutes to reach a parking orbit, then again at T plus 34 minutes for a 60-second burn to propel the Kplo spacecraft on the way to the Moon. The separation of the Kplo spacecraft was confirmed at T plus 40 minutes and 16 seconds. The probe was set to extend its solar panels and begin transmitting to ground controllers in around 20 minutes of deployment from the Falcon 9, according to KARI. When the Kplo spacecraft will arrive in lunar orbit, it will join spacecraft from NASA, India, and China that are currently exploring the Moon. DANURI's scientific payload will study the magnetic field of the Moon, measure the number of elements and molecules such as uranium, water, and helium-3, and photograph the dark craters at the poles where the sun never shines. If this mission is successful, it may act as a core of future space exploration. Do tell us your views about the contributions of South Korea in space exploration in the comment section below. If you've reached this far, like this video, subscribe to our channel, and press the notification bell so you don't miss any